So, yeah, the agent war is still going, and I know agent war sounds a little over the top, but if you've been living in Xcode lately, building Swift UI apps and using tools like Claude Code or Cursor to help you move faster, you've probably felt it. Every week, it feels like there's another move, another feature drop, another round in this strange little AI chess game. From the outside, it might just look like competition, but when you're a solo iOS dev, it's not abstract. This stuff directly shapes how you work. The wrong tool choice, that's hours lost, maybe days. A workflow that doesn't fit, you're looking at burnout territory. So when one of the players makes a big move, you pay attention. This week, that move came from Cursor. They've taken their AI coding agent, which has mostly lived in their visual IDE, and shoved it into the terminal. They're calling it the Cursor CLI. And my first thought was, why? Cursor's big advantage over Claude Code has been the nice, approachable visual environment. You can see your files drag and drop, work like you would in Xcode or VS Code, but with AI help. Now they're trying to play in the exact space Claude's been owning for months, the terminal. Turns out there's a reason. Real quick, I'm Daniel. I've been in the iOS game for almost 8 years, freelancing and shipping apps for other people. But since DubDub25, I've gone full solo dev, started building in public, and kind of figuring out this personal brand thing as I go. More on that for another video. Cursor is using OpenAI's newest model as a hook, literally letting you swap between GPT-5 and other models in the CLI without paying API per call rates. For solo devs who've looked at Claude Router or other API-based ways to try GPT-5 and winced at the bill, that's interesting. But is it worth shifting your workflow? That's what I wanted to find out. I installed it, I ran it, I tried to make it build something I'd actually ship in Swift UI. And yeah, there were some nice moments and a lot of gaps. Let's start from the top. So here's how I see it. The agent war isn't just two companies tossing out new models and seeing who's faster. It's not even about raw intelligence anymore. Not really. It's about depth, about workflow, about which tool can actually live inside the way you work without making you slow down to babysit it. Claude Code's CLI has been the clear leader there. It's like a tiny repo-aware operating system that just happens to live in your terminal. You get hooks that run your test suite automatically, call your weird little bash scripts, handle file edits without nuking unrelated code. You can spin up sub-agents like parallel little clods, each exploring a different corner of your code base without stepping on each other's toes. That flexibility matters when you're wearing all the hats: designer, coder, tester, bug triager, and there's nobody else to delegate to but future you. Cursor, until now, has been playing on a different field entirely. They built a visual IDE, and to be honest, it's nice. You've got your file tree, your side-by-side editing, your color themes. It feels approachable, like you can just drop in, start working, and not have to live in a black and white terminal all day. That's why so many of us have run Claude inside Cursor. You get Claude's deep repo handling with Cursor's clean, friendly UI, best of both worlds. So when I first heard they were making a CLI agent, my gut reaction was, why? Why leave the comfort zone? Especially when the terminal space is already so dominated by Claude. Then I saw the reason. GPT-5. You've probably already heard the hype train rolling. Bigger context window, sharper reasoning, spooky good ability to scaffold entire projects in a single go. I've seen it whip up some wild stuff, not always directly useful for Swift UI. It's still more impressive in a look what it can do way than a ship this to the App Store way, but it's hard to deny the raw horsepower. And now Cursor's dangling a pretty tempting offer in front of solo devs. Run GPT-5 right from your terminal, on their flat $20 a month plan. No juggling API keys, no staring at your usage bill after a late night prototyping binge. Just pick the model, start typing. In theory, that's huge. Imagine being in the middle of a Swift UI redesign, flipping between a couple of model variants, Claude for structured repo work, GPT-5 for those. What if we rethought this entire layout moments without paying extra or switching tools in practice? Well, tools like this always look perfect in the keynote slides. The real test is what happens when you point them at a messy, real-world code base and ask them to help without getting in the way? And that's exactly what I wanted to find out. So the first thing I did, because this is the first thing I always do with a new AI tool, was point it at a working Swift UI repo and ask it to scan for something small but useful. I didn't even try to break it, just, hey, can you check for any views missing accessibility labels? And nothing. That's when I went hunting for the basics, cursor rules, ignore files, the do not touch list that I consider bare minimum hygiene for letting an AI anywhere near my code. You can't tell it to ignore .env or skip my previews folder or leave that weird JSON mock alone. And I don't know about you, but as a solo dev, those little guardrails are not optional. I've been burned before. Late night, tired eyes. AI decides to fix something it shouldn't, and suddenly my local dev setup's toast. Then there's file handling, or right now the lack of it. In Cursor IDE, I can drag in a Swift file and it just gets it. It'll read it, parse it, work with it. In the CLI, I tried the same thing, even pointed it to some test files I'd made to, make this easy on it, and nothing. Dragging in an asset, not supported, it's like talking to someone about your code without being able to actually show them the code. Coming from Claude Code's CLI, this feels like stepping backwards. Claude lives in your repository. It's comfortable there. It respects ignore rules. It moves through your file tree like it's been living there for years. It remembers context between operations. Cursor CLI right now feels more like a model in a chat box with a couple of extra buttons. The idea of repo integration is there, but you can tell it hasn't moved in yet. The slash commands list tells the same story. Model is the clear headliner. And yeah, it's cool to just hop between GPT-5 and other models on the fly without dealing with API keys. But past that, auto run, new chat, clear in Vim mode, no slash hook to, automate my recurring tasks, no slash sub agent to keep different threads of work separate, no multi-step automation where I can say, scan this folder, refactor that file, then run my tests. And that's the thing, like for solo devs, the magic isn't just talk to a model. I mean, yeah, it's nice when an AI can answer questions, but what really matters is being able to work with a model. Have it move through your whole repo with awareness, run the boring stuff you forget, chain tasks together so you can stay in flow. Right now, Cursor CLI is not there. It's the very first version of something that could grow into that. But today, you're still the one holding the map, guiding it step by step and double checking its work. And that's fine for quick experiments, but not for deep in the repo Swift UI building. So here's where I'm at. If you live in Xcode every day, juggling Swift UI views, maybe wrangling a core data migration that's been haunting you for weeks, trying to keep your previews working while also shipping new features, and you're already using Claude Code as your main terminal agent, I just wouldn't switch yet. It's not that Cursor CLI is bad. It's just, well, it's missing all the stuff that makes Claude feel like an actual teammate instead of just a chat box in your terminal. No repo-wide awareness, no hooks to automate the repetitive grunt work. You're going to forget at 2 a.m. No sub agents to keep context clean when you're bouncing between fixing that one broken animation in onboarding view and adding analytics events in settings view. that repo awareness is the big one. Claude can walk through your entire project, respect, ignore rules, and still give you targeted help without touching things it shouldn't. Cursor CLI right now. It's more like a helpful visitor, knows some things, can do a task or two, but doesn't really know where everything lives or how it's connected. And as a solo dev, that lack of context means you end up doing the babysitting, explaining, re-explaining, double-checking every change. Now, I will say the flat plan model switching thing, that's real. I like it. If you've been curious about GPT-5 for Swift UI generation, maybe you want to see how it handles a tricky glass morphism layout or a playful widget animation. Cursor CLI is a cheap, frictionless way to mess around with that without pulling out your credit card for API calls. You can try it, see if the model clicks for you, and not worry about usage math in the background. But it's not a replacement for a deep repo aware agent, not for me. Right now, my stack's pretty set. Claude stays in the terminal for repo work because it just gets it. Cursor IDE stays on my machine for those moments when I want the visual editing experience or when I'm pairing Claude with a cleaner UI. And Cursor CLI, it's my little sidecar, the fun tool I spin up when I want to kick the tires on GPT-5, see how it handles a concept, or let it riff on something without touching my main code base. It's like the difference between your main workhorse and that quirky little app you keep on your iPad for brainstorming. One's how you get things done, the other's for exploration, for play, for those what if moments. Cursor CLI sits in that second bucket, and honestly, I'm fine with that for now. So yeah, that's where I've landed with Cursor's new CLI agent. Not just the bullet points from the feature list, but the actual feel of it, how it behaves when you drop it into the messy reality of a solo Swift UI workflow, when it's not just a demo, but a tool you're counting on to help you ship. It's got moments where it shines. That model switching trick with GPT-5 is honestly pretty great. Being able to tap into the newest model without worrying about API costs is a real perk. But for me, it's not quite the daily teammate I need yet. There's a gap between cool capability and trustworthy work partner, and right now Cursor CLI is still finding its footing. That said, I'm not uninstalling it because here's the thing about tools in this space. They change fast. The thing you poke at today and think, meh, not ready yet, can quietly turn into your go-to in just a few updates. And I'd rather have it close at hand when that switch flips than be starting from zero later. If you've tried Cursor CLI yourself, or if you've found your own weird, wonderful combo of tools that just works for you, I'd love to hear about it. Drop a comment and tell me what's been a win, what's been a total, what the heck just happened moment, and maybe even a story about the time an AI saved your skin on a bug you didn't even see coming. And hey, if this little breakdown gave you something to think about for your own setup, maybe helped you avoid a few rabbit holes, feel free to like the video, subscribe, or share it with another indie dev who's also deep in the Swift UI plus AI trenches. Until next time, keep crafting, keep experimenting, and don't let a clunky beta keep you from building something awesome. Peace.